Carrie from Central Library. Thank you for joining me today. Did you know that February is National Children's Dental Health Month? That's a mouthful. It is. And that is when the American Dental Association teams up with healthcare, education, and other organizations to promote the benefits of good dental health care. Today we have some very special guests with us who are here to tell us how the best ways to take care of our teeth and to keep our mouths happy and healthy. Please welcome from Matthews and Day Dentistry and Orthodontics, Carol Dudley and Captain Moeller.
Hi, good morning, boys and girls. My name is Carol, and I work for Dr. Day and Dr. Matthews' office. They are kids' dentists. And a dentist is somebody who takes care of our teeth, right? Well, I want to know who has been to the dentist. Raise your hand if you've been to the dentist. Okay, a lot of you have. But for those of you who haven't, let's talk about what we do. It is a lot of fun. What you do is you go into the office, you lay down in this really comfortable chair, and they give you some cool sunglasses to wear. And the reason why is because we've got this bright flashlight that shines in your mouth, and it makes your mouth light up really bright like a movie star with a spotlight on you. And he has you open super big like an alligator. So everybody give me a big alligator mouth. Oh my goodness, that's awesome. Now let me show you what he uses when you open big for him. He takes two things. There's this tiny magic mirror. Now we call it the magic mirror because even though it's little, we can see everything in your mouth with this. Now another thing they use is a little tooth counter, and this is what it looks like. Now, it kind of looks like a pick, but it doesn't hurt. Let me show you what it does. It lightly touches over each tooth one at a time, making sure all your teeth are strong and healthy. And he loves to count them to see how many you have. Now, probably most of you have 20 teeth right now, and that is a lot of teeth. That's as many as fingers and toes that we have. Now, let me show you what else we do. I'm the dental hygienist, and I use a very special toothbrush to clean your teeth. And this is what it looks like. Isn't it cute? It looks and feels like a pencil eraser. It's super soft. And what it does at the office, guys, is it spins around, and it not only cleans your teeth, but it tickles your teeth. Who's ticklish? Raise your hand. I know I am. So it is so much fun to get our teeth tickled and clean at the same time. But let's talk about what I'm cleaning off of our teeth. Did you know that we grow germs and bacteria all over our teeth every single day? Now you can't see the germs because they're invisible, but we like to call the germs sugar bugs. Let me show you what a sugar bug looks like. Here they are right here. Does this look very friendly? No, they're not friendly at all. What they like to do, they try to break our teeth down and make holes, okay? So let me show y'all on a picture of what they really look like. So the white things are teeth. And what's on top of there? The sugar bugs. Now we can't see them because they're invisible. So we have to know that they're always there, guys. Because if we don't brush them off every day and they stay on there too long, you know what could happen? They can make a hole in our tooth called a cavity. Let me show y'all what that looks like. First, I'm going to show you the parts of the tooth, and then I'll show you what a cavity looks like. Everybody touch your tooth in the front. Feel how strong it is. That part of your tooth is called the enamel. It's one of the strongest parts of our whole body. Now, what do you think this is? This is our gums, okay? Now, if I were to cut a tooth down the middle between two teeth, let me show you something. Look on the inside here. This is what it looks like inside these teeth, okay? Now, even though it's strong on the outside, because remember I told you it's really strong, on the inside it's really soft. That's the dentin. Now, the pink part is what keeps the tooth alive. That's the nerve of the tooth, okay? But now, let me show you inside this tooth. It looks the same, but what is that dark spot on top? Oh my goodness, that's a cavity. So if you're ever brushing one day and you see a dark spot that doesn't come off, where should we go? You're right, we should go to the dentist, because if we don't, guys, it doesn't stay little. It keeps getting bigger until look what it looks like. That is not a healthy tooth. We don't want y'all to get like that. Once the tooth gets like this, it starts to hurt. It doesn't feel very good, and it's not healthy. So if you ever see a dark spot, tell mom, say, take me to the dentist, because he's like magic. Gets rid of the cavity and makes the tooth look good as new again. Now, another thing we do at the dentist that's a lot of fun, we take pictures of your teeth called x-rays. What letter does x-ray start with? X. Yes, everybody make an X for me, just like this. X-rays, awesome. You can have x-rays taken all over your body, but at the dentist, we take them of your teeth. And what is so neat about it, guys, is it shows us not only the teeth you can see when you smile, but everybody feel your gums. You have on the top and on the bottom. And underneath there, did you know you have grown-up teeth? They're waiting to come in, yes. There is 32 of them. And as you get a little older and you start losing teeth and the new one comes in, it's going to seem so much bigger because it's like twice the size. But it's supposed to be that way. And everybody's at a different age when they lose their first tooth. You might be 5, you might be 6, and you might be 7. So everybody be patient because everybody's going to lose the same amount of baby teeth, which is 20. Now, let me show y'all what x-rays look like. They're really cool. X-rays are dark, so I'll hold them up to a light. But what's so neat about it, it shows us our baby teeth and our grown-up teeth that we can't see yet. So it really kind of looks like a shark's mouth, doesn't it? Look at all those teeth in there. Oh my goodness. So it's a lot of fun to see this because you'll lose teeth off and on till you're about 12 years old. Now let me show you another x-ray that's cool to take. It's a head x-ray. Look at that. Now that's a side view picture of our head. Now what do y'all think this is? That's our neck bones. You can feel the back of your neck and feel those, but that's the top of our spine. And then way up in here, what do you think's in there? That's our brain that makes us smart. And then this shows how our teeth fit together. So taking x-rays are so much fun, and so is going to the dentist. Let me tell you what you get when you're done, guys. You get a new toothbrush. So make sure if you haven't been, tell mom and dad to take you, okay? But now we've got to take care of our teeth every day. So raise your hand if you brush your teeth every day. I love to see hands. That's awesome. Now, if you don't yet, you could start today. From now on, what should we do every day after breakfast? Brush our teeth. But the most important time of day is when? Right before we go to bed, after we've had our snack, the last thing we do, let's go brush those sugar bugs off. Because even though we brushed them off in the morning, guess what? By the time we go to bed, they're all back on there again. So make sure that can be your job to remember that. Mom and Dad will be so proud of y'all if you brush before you go to bed without them even telling you to. Now let me show y'all. This is a size toothbrush I'd like for y'all to use because your mouths are still small. So don't use a big toothbrush like mom and dad. The bristles need to be very soft because there's 3 things that we want to brush in our mouth. Not just our teeth, we want to brush our gums. And does anybody know what else? Our tongue. Make sure to brush your tongue every time because the sugar bugs love to get on our tongue. Now, who in here takes vitamins at home? Raise your hand. Oh my goodness, I love seeing hands because vitamins are so, so important for our body. Did you know there's vitamins for your teeth? It's called fluoride. Everybody say fluoride. You can get fluoride at the drugstore like Walgreens or even HEB. And what you do, let me show you what it looks like. It comes in really good flavors. This is grape. And what you do is at night after you brush your teeth with toothpaste, brush it on really good, and it makes your teeth super strong while you're sleeping. Now, you're not going to rinse this out like you do toothpaste. You're going to spit it out and then just go to bed, okay? So let's make sure to get some of this today or as soon as you can. Now, I'm going to introduce y'all to my good friend. His name is Dudley. Say hi, Dudley. Isn't he cute? Now, Dudley has his own special toothbrush. This is his toothbrush right here. Now, I'm going to show y'all the best way to brush your teeth. What we want to do, guys, we do not want to be in a hurry. We want to take our time. We don't want to get in there and start scrubbing back and forth or up and down. But what I want you to do is take the toothbrush and go little circles like wheels of a choo-choo train. Everybody do that for me. Choo-choo, little circles. Good job. Now, what we want to do, guys, is we want to do the top teeth first, then the bottom teeth, and only brush two teeth at a time because that's the length of your toothbrush. So let's start on the top. Remember, I told you we've got to brush our gums. So we're going to start in the back, on top, angle the toothbrush up, and go choo-choo little circles, just like that. And then you do two more until you've gone all the way around. Now I'm going to come back and do the inside. It kind of tickles up in there, but we've got to get those sugar bugs out that love to hide. So I'm brushing little circles, brushing how many teeth at a time? Two teeth at a time, all the way around. Then I've still got to get the chewing surface where we chew our food in the back. So let's take the toothbrush, put it flat against the back teeth, and make little circles on both sides. And now we're going to go to the bottom. But on the bottom, you see where the gums are? They're below the teeth. So to do that, we're going to angle the toothbrush down and go little circles, brushing two teeth at a time, all the way around. Now, what do you think gets in the way on the inside on the bottom? The tongue gets in the way. So everybody lift your tongue to the sky like this. And then you can angle the toothbrush down and get in there really good. And brush two teeth at a time, all the way around. Then don't forget the chewing surface of the back teeth. What else am I gonna brush? You're right, the tongue, we can't forget that. Now, after I've done that, can you believe the teeth aren't all the way clean yet? We didn't get in between our teeth. What are we gonna use, guys? Dental floss, that's right. Let me show y'all what that looks like. Dental floss. It looks like a piece of string, and it comes in different flavors and colors. Any kind is okay. If your teeth are really close together, make sure to get wax floss because it'll help it slide through the teeth better. But what you do, guys, you only have to do this once a day, so do it at night when you're not rushed for school. So take a big piece of floss, wrap it around your middle fingers like this, and with your index finger and your thumb, don't just push the floss up because that might hurt. You want to seesaw back and forth. Everybody do that for me. Seesaw, seesaw, back and forth. Good job. And if you have a hard time getting in the back, let mom and dad help you. Just make sure to open really big for them like you did for me a minute ago. All right. I want to talk about one more thing before we go get my friend, and that's mouth guards. Who in here is playing sports? Raise your hand. Oh, I see a lot of you are playing sports. If you are, guys, whether it's soccer, baseball, basketball, karate, any of those, tell mom to get you a plastic mouth guard. You can get these at Walgreens or you can get them at Academy. They come in all kinds of cool colors to match your uniform, and you bite into it as you're playing, and that way if you get hit in the mouth, your teeth will be protected. So don't forget your mouth guards. All right, let me go see where my special friend is. I'll be right back. Okay, I found my friend Captain Moeller. Y'all wave to Captain Moeller. Isn't he cute? Have you ever seen a tooth as big as he is before? Oh my goodness, look at him. He's got his own special toothbrush because I'm gonna brush him today to make him happy. He's got sugar bugs all over him, but you can't see them because they're invisible. So he's asking me to brush him right now. Now he loves to be clean, but he's very ticklish. So let's get the front of him first. Here we go. Brush, 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 little circles. All right, Captain Moeller, he's loving this. Okay, turn around, let's get the back of you now. Brush, 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 little circles. Good job, Captain Moeller. Turn back around and we gotta do the top of you. Brush, 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 little circles. What a happy tooth he is. Now, are we done? No, I've still got to get the sides of him, remember? We've got to use my special floss for him. So I'm going to take it, wrap it around my fingers, and we're going to seesaw. Let's do this side first. Seesaw, seesaw, all the way down and all the way up. Now, let me come to this side. Seesaw, seesaw, all the way down and all the way up. And now he's a happy, clean tooth. Everybody give him a hand. Oh, my goodness. Look at Captain Moeller. See, guys, this is how our teeth feel when we clean them every day. So don't leave any out. Make sure to get them all nice and clean. cleaned 2 times a day. Now, he was going to talk about one more thing. We can't forget snacks. I know we all love to eat snacks, right? Well, there are some good snacks and there are some bad snacks. So let's see what I have over here. What about an apple? Is that a good snack? Oh, Captain Miller loves to eat apples. Everybody do a thumbs up for apples. He eats those every day. What about a chocolate donut? Ooh, it may taste good, but it's loaded with sugar. So let's give that a thumbs down. Even though it tastes really good, we know it's not good for our teeth. What about a carrot? Carrots are so good for us. They're good for our eyes and for our teeth. So let's do a double thumbs up on that one. That's such a good snack. What about Skittles candy? Oh my goodness, this little bag of candy. Look at all that sugar. That's a lot of sugar to go on our teeth. Captain Muller says, no way, stay away from me. What about a banana? Yes, we love bananas. They're so good for us. He eats those all the time. What about drinking Coke or Pepsi, guys? This bottle has got all that sugar. Imagine drinking all that sugar. Our teeth definitely don't like that. And Captain Muller never does that. You know what he sticks with? He either drinks water or he drinks milk because milk makes us so strong. Show him your muscles from drinking milk every day. Look at how strong he is. Oh my goodness. Look at there. Who wants their teeth to be strong and healthy like Captain Muller? Raise your hand. I know I do. So we've got to take care of our teeth to do that. So what we need to do, guys, is visit the dentist 2 times a year. Okay, everybody hold up a 2. Good job. 2 times a year. Tell mom and dad if you haven't been. We need to brush our teeth 2 times a day. Make sure to floss 1 time a day. Use the fluoride every night before you go to bed. And make sure to wear your mouth guards if you play sports. And always eat and drink healthy if you can. Now, every now and then, if you're at a party and there's some candy or cake, that's okay. But go home and brush your teeth as soon as you can, okay, whenever you get home. All right, y'all, we're great listeners today. Thank you so much. Everybody give Captain Muller a hand.
Thank you, Carol and Captain Muller. That was so much fun, and I learned so much. You know, we also have books here in the library that you can come and check out that have great information about taking care of your teeth, going to the dentist, and the tooth fairy. As a matter of fact, Miss Brandy's reading one right now. Hey, Miss Brandy, what you reading?
Oh, yes, I am enjoying this wonderful book by Blue Apple Publishers, called ABC Dentist. It's here in our library for you to check out. It's such a great book.
Well, tell me about that book.
It talks about the ABCs of going to the dentist. Things like x-rays and cavities and D for dental floss. You get the idea. It makes going to the dentist a much more relaxed experience for you when you read about what to expect in this great little book. So don't forget, it's here for you to enjoy and it's here for you to check out. This book was written by Harriet Ziefer and the paintings are done by Liz Murphy. Miss Carrie, I see that you have a great book. Can you tell me what it is you're reading?
Yes, Miss Brandy, I am reading The Tooth Book, A Guide to Healthy Teeth and Gums by Edward Miller. It's published by Holiday House.
Miss Carrie, what is that book about? Tell us all.
This book is full of information about dental health care. It talks about what to expect when you go to the dentist, the best ways to keep your teeth and gums healthy, the right foods to eat. It has a diagram that shows the parts of the tooth, just like Miss Carol showed you. And it has a timeline of when you will lose your primary or baby teeth, all the way up to when you have your grown-up permanent teeth. What else did I like about this book? It has some great trivia, which is little bits of information about dental health through the years. And it also gives the names of the teeth and what their jobs are. Did you know that your teeth had different jobs? Well, they do. I really enjoyed this book. Hey, Miss Brandy, what you reading?
Oh my goodness, Miss Carrie, this is such a great book brought to you by Viking Publishing. It's one of my favorite authors. It's written by Anna Dudney. Llama Llama Loose Tooth Drama. This is a brand new book in the collection.
Well, tell me about that book.
It just fits right in talking about dental health and going to the dentist. This is a fiction book, and it's all about Llama and how he's so scared because all of a sudden he has this loose tooth, like a loose tooth. Yes, it's really cute. The book is a rhyming book, and I love rhyming books, and it talks all about how he is going to have to get this loose tooth out of his mouth. And he learns all about the tooth fairy and that the tooth fairy sometimes leaves small amounts of money. And then all of a sudden he's a little scared because guess what? He can't find the loose tooth because it's out of his mouth all of a sudden. So he's wondering if the tooth fairy is going to forget to come because he doesn't have the tooth anymore. You'll have to read it to find out what happens. Miss Carrie, I see that you have a great book. Can you tell me what it is you're reading?
Oh, Miss Brandy, I love this book. This is Tallulah the Tooth Fairy CEO. It's by Dr. Tamara Pizzoli, and the pictures are by Federico Fabiani.
Miss Carrie, what is that book about? Tell us all.
This book is about Tallulah, and she is the chief executive officer, the CEO, of her company that she founded. It's called Tooth Titans, and they collect teeth, of course, because she's a tooth fairy. And it tells you about how she spends her days running her company, how she balances her life with such important work, and also how she balances the three P's, which is passion, purpose, and what pay. Then one day she has a challenge when a little boy loses his lost tooth. What will she do? How will she handle that if she cannot go and collect the tooth? Well, her trusty team of advisors comes and helps her to come up with the perfect solution. So those are just a few of the great books we have in the library. We hope to see you soon. Bye!
So I hope you enjoyed these books regarding dental health, and I hope that you come to the library very soon to see Miss Carrie and Miss AJ and, of course, yours truly, Miss Brandy. Have a great day.